Dear students, today we will discuss about the role of schema in database systems. So before going into the role of schema in database systems, let's try to envision the problem. The problem is that when we have a database and that database have all of the information, but we provide only specific information to specific users and we do not open all of the information to everyone. So for example, in virtual university, there is a database and that database contains student record, faculty records, examination record, etc. So whenever student logins into this database, student will be given only the access of activities related to students. So they cannot check that who is the faculty member, what is his or her full name, address, date of birth, salary, etc. So all of such information will be restricted from the student. So someone placing an order should not have access to company's financial data. So for example, you are going to put order on eBay system or Amazon system. So you should not be allowed to see that what information is available within their database and what is the financial data available in that company. Similarly, employer supervisor can ask for the information related to employees, but they cannot be given access to corporate inventory, that what is basically holding the company is holding and what are the sale records, etc. So such a thing is implemented as schema or sub-schema. So what is a schema? A schema is a description of the entire database structure that is used by the database software to maintain the database. And sub-schema is part of or a description of only that portion of the database pertinent to a particular user's need. So let's have some other examples. Schema of university database include student complete information, courses registered by the students, and student advisor information, faculty member enrollment history, etc. So all of such information is available in the university website. However, registrar should not be able to see the employment history of the faculty members, but can see that what student is allotted or which student is advised by which advisor or supervisor. And similarly, the sub-schema of payroll system, the payroll system is having all of the record of the employees, that how much salary they are being paid, bonuses, extra time, etc. So such a sub-schema of payroll department would provide the employment history of each faculty member, but would not include the linkage between student and advisor. So they don't need such an information, that they are not going to control, or they are not going to identify that which faculty member is advising which student. And similarly, examination department should not be able to access salary information of the company. So today we have learned about role of schema. We have discussed the motivation, that why schema and sub-schemas are built. And then we have discussed with number of examples that why and how very restricted information is displayed to restricted parties within the company or that environment.